Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. I just thought I would show a little recap of that cutscene there just because it's starting the main portion of the game here. This village, it starts like a puzzle in itself, so you're gonna have to use your wits to progress through the game here. Don't worry if you don't have much wits, I'll help you through it. I'm just joking around here. Anyway, let's talk to the kids. See what they're up to. No, I did not hear this because I just woke up. Woo! It must be awesome because she's talking in caps lock. So apparently it is quite expensive. 30 rupees, in fact. We're going to have to grind for them to get that slingshot. But don't worry, I'll show you how to get cash as quickly as possible. Like, you can find rupees inside the grass, such as that there. There should be a rock somewhere that you can pick up in one of these grassy areas. It's not usually like these rocks. Definitely not that one. wait, maybe it's this one. Ah, there we go, blue rupee. Those are worth 5, green are worth 1, yellow are worth 10, there's other valuables as you'll see along the game. I'll get to them as we go. I just want to try and collect as much pocket change as I possibly can here. Okay, let's go. I'm already pretty close to the goal because I know there's a spot where you can get a yellow rupee and that'll bring me up to 18. I believe there's also a 5 rupee. The place I'm talking about is way up there on top of that limb at the center of the screen. You'll see once I get over there in a second. What do you have to say, mister? Interesting. So there appears to be some sort of hive of up there, and it's kind of problematic. And the cat's gone. That's another problem. Oh, I forgot to talk to someone over here, actually. This is going great, isn't it? There's one more kid over here, and he's over by your horse. How's it going? Indeed I do. I was planning on sleeping in, but apparently I gotta get money for a slingshot and get a fishing rod. It's a big issue. Anyway, let's go back through here. And the first thing that you want to do is go and actually retrieve a baby's carriage. You'll see what I mean once I get there. I'm actually going to do this out of order just to show you a little bit of a lull that they programmed into the game here. But I suppose I'll go through this tutorial here. Z-target him and then press the A button and you can talk to people from a distance. It's rather handy in certain places that you see people like on top of pillars like this. And you can climb up vines by pressing up. I said pressing up, not left. And then it'll be like, yeah, you did such a good job, and stuff like that. And, oh, look at that, there's the cat that seems to be missing. Well, I don't know, I think a cat could catch a fish. Cats are pretty smart. I'm sure cats have caught fish before. And you know what, I should show you another little cutscene before I go. It's inside the shop here. Before I go and get the little baby carriage thing. Hey, how's it going? Rosie O'Donnell, you definitely don't look too well. Oh, it's so sad. Yeah, she's the owner of that cat that you've seen out there. Isn't that interesting? The cat is looking for a fish, but she scolded the cat for stealing her fish. I wonder why, then, if it's full. Anyway, you can't do anything here in general, but you can go get that baby carriage. I've been stalling out. I'm just sort of showing you around the village during this sort of... Why did you climb left again? During this introduction part of sorts, and to jump across gaps, you just run towards them in a straight line, and you want to run all the way over to here, grab a piece of grass, and use it! This is different than the grass you used to call a nope towards you. And you have yourself a buddy! It's a hawk! Link is quite the animal lover in this game, that's for sure. Anyway, see that bouncing monkey way in the distance, just above the center of my cursor? Aim the hawk towards the monkey and release it with the A button. Voila! That's how you get the baby carriage. Now, as I said, I'm doing this a little bit out of order, just to show you a little funny thing they programmed into the game. Now, jump back across there without falling into the water, because that would suck. I'll take the baby carriage over here. Now, normally this lady here would she'd say that her baby carriage got taken away by the monkey. But she'll be like, oh my, Link, I've been looking for that cradle. Oh, it's called a cradle. Why do I keep saying baby carriage? And well, whatever, I got it back. I made it when my first child was born. I have cherished it all these years. Did you know all this somehow? Did you find and bring it back here to me on purpose? My thanks to you. Yeah, that dialogue is different because she didn't tell me about her stolen carriage. Carriage or cradle first. And so anyway, she wants to take this back to the house. She's really slow, so just run ahead of her and go back to her house. And sure enough, she just teleports right in front of you. You're welcome. And she gives me the fishing rod. Yeah, that was the fishing rod that kid told me to go get it from his dad, but turns out she gives it to you instead. It's kind of odd like that. So now that we have a fishing rod, we can catch some fish. Why is this important? Well, you shall soon see. But let's first go inside her house just to give a little exploration. There's not all that much inside her house, but I have to say the houses in Twilight Princess are really, really detailed, even if there isn't much to explore in them. And I guess that's really all there is to show. That's just how things go, I suppose. Alright, now what you want to do is go by where that cat is. Rolling is a little bit faster than running in Zelda games for some reason. I guess I'll go over there for the heck of it, talk to the mayor. Hey, how's it going? Morning, Link! This sounds like a problem. Oh, poopers! Caps lock! Okay, try and block the goats. Grab it with the A button and whip it over. You don't really have to do this, I think. Well, you might have to do this a little bit later, but I'm just, as I said, exploring the area just to give you a feel for the village early in the game. And can I go inside his house this early? I think... No, I can't. I guess I can't. That's kind of sad. Isn't she a little mean? Anyway, let's move on and actually go by that cat. You get to the cat by going through here. Oh, you can also pick up pumpkins and throw them. They sometimes contain rupees that you can also use to grind for that elusive 30 rupees that I was talking about earlier. Ooh, blue one. Very nice. And actually, I think that's good enough for what I'll be getting shortly. Let's go in this house just to check it out before I go behind it. Do-do-do-do-do. And hello there. Oh, are you afraid of me? I won't hurt you. Oh, you're so precious. Oh, you're so cute. Oh, goodness gracious. Yeah, he's definitely afraid of me for some reason. All right, what do you have to say to me, lady? A shield, huh? Interesting. Remember that shield. Hint, hint, wink, wink. Anyway, that's all I wanted to show you in here, although I could show you the other details that are in the house. As you can see, that a lot of the stuff on the sides aren't like printed as they were in other Zelda games, like in Ocarina of Time, like you've seen before. They're all 3D rendered, which is rather nice. As I said, there's a lot of detail put inside the houses. Alright, to the cat we go! No more dilly-dallying. Wait, actually, what is this? Oh, okay. Just a little sign saying whose house is what. There's the cat! Hello, kitty, how's it going? Apparently not very good. So, now that we're at this pier, we gotta select our fishing rod. How do we do that? We press the minus button on the Wii remote. It's probably different for the GameCube controls. I don't know the GameCube controls because I don't have it. And set the fishing rod with the B button and go back with the A button. Now, all we have to do is catch two fish. Press the B button, hold it, and plop it into the water. When the top of that bobber, the very tip of the red, goes underneath where the water is rippling, jerk back on it like that, and you'll have a fish. Pull it in, Link! Pull it in! Yay! So they're apparently a very common fish with very swirly scales as well. And now you'll notice that the fish gives you a heart for some reason. It's probably happy for it to let you go. And you'll notice that the cat is a little more intrigued. This is why you have to catch two fish. Because it notices that the first fish that you caught, I mean, that you're catching fish, and yet it can't seem to be able to catch a fish. That's the reason why it's intrigued now, because it wants a fish. Yeah! Vibrating Wii remote! And it's another green gill, apparently. But this time, woo! Even Link gets stunned. It's like, wow! Voila! Now the cat is back by its rightful owner. And this fishing rod looks really weird when I roll. It doesn't make much sense whatsoever. I'm putting that sucker away. Hey, wait. What is this ladder over here? I might as well climb up here. As I said, I would like to show the area a little bit. Anything of interest over here? Probably. I don't recall going up here before. What is up here? Probably rupees. I'd like to hide rupees on high places at this village for some reason. Like this yellow rupee, which is worth 10. Very nice. That's rather easy to get. And there's also some grass growing on top of the house for some reason. Why is this person planting grass on top of their house? I have no idea. Maybe to call hawks whenever they need it or something. Anyway, now the next thing you want to do is go into this house, well, the shop, and Rosie O'Donnell will be delighted! The reason why the cat wanted the fish was because the cat felt bad for stealing her fish, and so he gave a fish back to her by using the fish that I caught. So in turn, it actually stole a fish from her. It felt bad, so it ended up stealing a fish from me to give to her so it would feel better about itself. It doesn't make much sense, but that's just how the side quest works, and she's apparently been drinking some of this milk. I'm rather germophobic, so I'm not all too keen about this, to be honest, but I would like to use up this milk just so I can have a bottle. Now that I have two items, you can switch them onto the D-pad's directions in either left to right or down, and you can go back like that. Now you can switch items by simply pressing whichever direction on the control stick is, and then you'll be able to swap it as such. Oh, backwash. But the reason why I want to clear out that bottle is because I want to get something a little bit later. I don't have to return the empty bottle. Those bottles are really important in Zelda games. Just saying, I don't have enough money for that slingshot just yet. I'm 4 rupees shy, but don't worry, I'll be able to get that in just a second. And you can see you can buy more milk. I believe milk covers 4 hearts per drink, so that would have recovered 4 hearts of my life. And the slingshot is the thing that we want. But I'm going to be getting some free bee larvae in just a second. So let's leave the shop. And the reason why I want to why I want to empty the bottle is because I need some something to contain it, actually. And you can actually use the bee larvae to recover health as well. I think I turned left on that, on these vines here, because I am, I mean, the camera is pointed left. Anyway, remember the bee's nest that was above the house? We are going to knock it down with our hawk buddy. Alright, so aim yourself towards the hive. Unleash the hawk! Voila! And the guy should be rather delighted. I didn't mean to do that. I want to jump across to the roof and then jump down, but I'll do it that way, otherwise I'm going to roll myself off the edge. What do you have to say for yourself, mister? That's because I am brilliant like that, and because I've played this game before. So anyway, now that you knocked down this nest, well, I knocked down this nest, you'll knock it down later. You can scoop stuff into the bottle if the bottle is selected on B. Voila! And you can also use the bee larva as fish baits. Just like that. It'll make the fish quite happy. And, actually the bee larva is, it recovers less health than the, milk would. So actually, maybe I should have kept the milk after all. the bee larva will attract fish a lot better than just the rod alone. In case you didn't get that, it's like putting a worm on a hook. Anyway, the reason why I'm climbing up here is because there's something you want to get very, very carefully. Swing the camera around if you can. Look at that! Look at that! Yep, that's why I wanted to come up here. The bees would get in your way if you didn't knock that down. Careful. Careful. Get it straight so I can just press up. Yeah, I think that's good. Reverse. One foot is off the thin branch, but that's okay. No, no, no. Do not turn like that, Link. This is very frightening. Alright. There we go. Now I can jump down. If you don't want to take damage when you fall, just hold forward on the control stick and you'll automatically roll and not take damage. I don't believe this works if you jump from way too high of a position, but otherwise you will prevent damage from a distance like that. Obviously that wouldn't happen in real life, but this isn't real life, of course. So now I have enough money to buy the slingshot! Yeah, I am a naughty guy, but please... Please do not meet up with me in my bedroom. And that's all I'm going to be buying from here. Now we got to go meet back up with the kids. That is just outside and to the left. Whoop. Yeah, that's back in front of my house, if you don't remember. And the kids will be quite delighted. I should probably select it with the... Hello, what you got there? Ooh, awesome! I love gifts! Especially when they're free. You can never turn down something that's free and you can't complain about it. Why did Link give him, like, a glare? It looks like he just glared at him evilly or something like that. Anyway, I'm going to equip the slingshot. Oh, actually, I shouldn't replace items like that. And, oops, I did not mean to do that. I wanted to switch. There we go. Well, I wasted a bee larva, but whatever. Anyway, I'll speak to the kids and be like, "Whoa! He has a slingshot! This is so awesome! He's so rich and popular and stuff like that!" I have no idea what I'm saying here. So now they're gonna teach you how to use the slingshot, essentially. But using items is pretty much all the same. You just press the B button to use it, though they all have a different feel to them. And these kids act like they're soldiers or something like that. I use the control stick to aim, but you gotta first whip out the slingshot, hold the B button, and now you can aim with the control stick. Look around with I mean, look around with the control stick, and you can aim with the Wii Remote's pointer. It's probably different for the GameCube version, of course. And let's shoot some kids. Nah, they dodge your attacks each and every time. It's just a fun little thing that they added into the game as well. To say, you cannot hurt those kids whatsoever. And you'll notice that she was the one that was saying, ah, this is boring. Why do you guys care about this so much? And she's the one that's all excited after I shoot the... Yeah, see? Okay, now you want to shoot the rest of the targets that are around this area, including the pumpkin-headed scarecrows. You got to shoot their heads right off. This is all very easy to do and very simple to go through. Voila! I don't think you can lock on to those targets with the Z button, though. Well, maybe you can lock on to the, lock on to the scarecrows, but not the targets on the trees and stuff like that. You gotta manually aim for those. By the way, why does Link have scarecrows anyway? He doesn't have any crops, unless that grass is, like, rice or something like that, but I highly doubt that. Alright, let's see what's inside his house. We might as well... Oh, wait, what is this on here? What are we supposed to do about this spider that I did not know about ahead of time? This is a skull tula, by the way. Actually, maybe it is a... It's probably a skull wall tula, actually. The skull tulas are the ones that fall down from the ceiling. Skull wall tulas are the ones that hang on the wall and block things like your house there. So, yeah, you shoot it with the slingshot and you go inside your house. And you get yourself a prize that was delivered that you gave a rather snide look to. Delivered by that guy, I mean. It is a wooden sword. And now you go back outside by the kids. That's really all there was that you had to do in here. And down we go. And now that I have a sword, they'll be like, whoa, is that a sword? Oh, goodness. They're always excited when I get a new item. They seem more excited than I am, actually. Yeah, sure, why not? This is also pretty funny here. They want to be taught how to use a sword, right? However, they're the ones that do the teaching here. Watch, the slice. You just swing the Wii Remote, right? Wah! It's like, see, they know what they're doing, but they're still asking you to demonstrate it. So the vertical slice is done by Z-targeting and then swinging the Wii Remote. She is absolutely delighted by this violence. Wah! Oh, they wanted a stab, but I thought they wanted to do the vertical slice first. That's what they said in the dialogue. Alright, so this time, Z-target, tilt forward, and then swing. I'll tilt the control stick forward towards the scarecrow. The twirly thing is known as the spin attack. And you just shake the nunchuck. See, they know how to do this. Or at least that little one does. That little one is really, really smart. So anyway, you shake the nunchuck. It's quite a spectacular move, and it's really handy. You can only do it every so many seconds, though, but it's not limited enough to de-break this move, because it's very handy when enemies are all around you. Alright, jump attack. All you have to do is Z targeting. Voila! You're welcome! You don't seem to be delighted to get it, do you? So this village, as you can tell, has been having a little bit of trouble with monkeys. Oh, geez. Uh-oh.